another edition of the Don Miller Show. Hello, everybody. Welcome again to another edition of the Don Miller Show.
We're starting off like we always start off. Turn your microphone on.
Thank you very much, Holly Holloman. You are listening to Freestyle Friday right here on the Don Miller Show. This is when we just let it all hang out. Say what? Joining me, as always, my good friend, Deacon in Training. He has been excommunicated from many churches. But he say
that's
the,
so mean, man.
The usher boy need to stop wearing
them
shawl dresses.
My mama told me to tell you to stop saying that.
The usher boy wearing them shawl dresses. Then they bent over, pick up their handkerchief. God is good. Okay. Oh, hello, Holly Holloman.
What's going on, Don?
Joining us in the studio today, of course, we have guests, and I think we need to put on our... we need to be very professional with our guest in the studio.
Yeah, well, we started out that way.
Okay. We're going to do this all over again. We're going to start all over again, okay? And we're going to do this right
because we have special guests.
We don't want people to think that we just raggedy all the time.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So we're going to do this all over again. One, two, and three.
Four.
Here we go again.
Everybody, welcome again to a Friday edition of the Don Miller Show. My name is Don Miller. Joining me, as always, my good buddy Holly Holloman.
Hello,
I sound like
Donna.
That dude in the strip club. Coming down now, chocolate.
You wouldn't know.
No, I wouldn't. Okay, I heard.
Okay.
We have a guest in the studio joining us. As a matter of fact, we have two guests joining us right here on the Don Miller Show. My good friend, she is one of the few women in America that is clicked on more than a million times a month with her clothes on. Joining us in the studio from ESPN, my good friend, absolutely, Jemele Hill.
Oh, that's a great way to put
also
that.
Also joining us in the studio.
Oh, great applause, great applause. He's right there on it.
Also joining us in the studio, my good friend, he is the Black Republican from Detroit, Michigan.
What are you?
The only Black Republican from Detroit, Michigan.
Wow.
My good buddy, Mr. D. Hey, Mr. D.
Oh, there's a handcuff. Hey. Yeah,
okay. Don, you know what? That was a hell of an introduction.
Oh, thank you so much. Jemele, really. You
thank
get a
you.
Lot of hits on your website.
And I'm so glad that I can do this without taking my clothes off. That's awesome.
And you can do it, but you're off the shoulder right now.
I am.
You know what? It's amazing.
See, how you do me?
You're off the shoulder right now. You're off the shoulder. But you know the great thing about
sexy.
It? The great thing, got to keep the sexy in your life.
Okay.
The great thing also, we're doing something that we've never done before on the Don Miller Show. We are actually being
videotaped. Yeah. So you'll be able to see it on YouTube. We have a crew in here that's videotaping everybody, and we can't say their name because they are a secret video company, and they only videotape like top secret shows.
He works for the CIA and the Playboy Channel.
Pretty much.
You dropped it like it's hot. You've probably seen this gentleman before.
Yeah, pretty much. But it's great. You know, I'm like, we got celebrities in the studio. That's really special. You know,
well, again.
And I just want to say this, that Jemele, you look even better on radio than you do on TV.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
Take that either way. That can be taken out of context right
now. No, it's all good. I'm just happy to be amongst family.
Oh, that's good.
Don knows I love him dearly and Holly you as well. And it is a real treat because as a sports writer, columnist, television analyst, I don't get to do stuff like this very often.
Well,
I can come and take my shoes off, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Might have to unpop my bra strap at some point, you know?
Wow. That's why she brought her husband.
Exactly.
Republican from Detroit.
See, I can't say his full name because he's a Republican.
From
you know,
Detroit.
I'm from Detroit. I don't want to get beat up when I leave here. So, you know.
Okay, we can say his name. Matter of fact, why don't you say your name, okay?
Vincent Albert.
That ain't even your name.
That is his name.
Vincent Albert, better known in Detroit, Michigan as Mr. D. He is he's been known as a slumlord, but most Republicans are.
Wow.
Wow.
But people need somewhere to live, even though the conditions might be a little horrid. You know, people need somewhere to live. Huh? Everybody don't need water.
I don't believe he signed up for this when he came.
He listens to the show. Okay, yeah. Everybody don't need water or heat.
Oh, man.
Hey, but you know, once again, thank you so much for joining us on the show. You can visit us on the web at www.thedonmillershow.com. Click on Listen Live and take a seat next to Holly in the studio. You can also check us out on Facebook. We have a lot of listeners who stream via Facebook, and that is The Don Miller Show on Facebook. You can give us a call, 1-800-785-4DON. That's 1-800-785-4366. Or on the local number, if you're calling from the local area, 407-894-1680.
You do that pretty good, Don.
Do it again.
Well, you know, I'm sure they got
so
all those numbers.
There's so much going on in the media, and this is Freestyle Friday. We've been out of the studio for about a week now. We are back. I've been traveling, and Holly's been taking on a new profession.
Yes,
and congratulations, Holly.
Appreciate that.
And it is great to have you back in town, Jamil. You know, I watched you last week while I was traveling. You were in Los Angeles, and then you're in Connecticut.
No, I'm in Los Angeles next week. I was in Connecticut.
Wherever you were, you were doing your thing.
Yeah, I was trying to. I'm shocked. You know, Don, you was a Chicago guy. Yeah. I know you watched the Bulls Celtics game last night.
We got to talk a little sports.
Yeah.
We got to talk a little bit, okay?
Yeah, we actually said we're going to stay away from sports because that's what you do all the time.
No, but that game was
that was outstanding.
That was one of the best games ever. I've ever seen.
Now, Don, you know, both of you guys have great sports knowledge. Do you think that is a lot of people are saying this is the best series ever in NBA history.
I've never seen a series like this.
I can't remember anything. Well,
Holly,
I really can't. We ain't gonna talk about
Bob Cousy. You can't ask Holly.
Oh, he's gonna say
I'm old. You seen George Mikan.
You still got rabbit ears on your TV.
He ain't even got the digital yet.
George Mikan had a hook shot. I ain't never seen it. He was guard. Who was he guarding?
That's the same man that led the freedom train back in the 70s or the 60s.
But getting back to that game, Jamil, as an analyst, someone who gets paid to talk about this, was that the most amazing finish down? The overtime was better than the game.
It was unbelievable. I mean, I think, you know, the one thing you look for in a great sports game is something that constantly has momentum, constantly has pressure. And that's, you know, that's one of the reasons why I thought that Giants-Patriots game was better than this Arizona Steelers Super Bowl.
Absolutely.
You know, the last 2 minutes were good, but what about the rest of the game?
You're sitting on the edge of your seat.
You're sitting on the edge of your seat this whole game, and, you know, it was so many great plays, and I think the play of the game has got to be when Joakim Noah stole the ball from Paul Pierce, went the length of the court, and then dunked on him.
You know what's amazing, though? Somebody need to go get that little boy some big old draws, okay? Because he got some big old one of them, you know, things.
Onions, dude.
That young fella right there, okay?
Yeah.
I just drove by the Orlando Arena, and I want to address this for 1 minute. And they got a Superman cape hanging on the arena. Hello, Orlando Magic listeners. You don't have a Superman.
No, you don't.
A big guy who's athletic. He could got a 40-inch vertical. He is not a great player. Great players wear big draws. I have not seen Dwight Howard with a big pair of draws on this series.
Yeah. Wow.
Tell me if I'm wrong. Yeah,
no, you're not wrong.
Come on.
My continual beef with Dwight Howard is that he's not a guy. I said this on the show on First Take, the show I do with Skip Bayless. I said this earlier. For the playoffs, I would rather have Yao Ming.
Oh, absolutely.
And the reason that I said that was because Yao Ming's an 87% free throw shooter. You can go to him down the stretch and control the game. You cannot do that with Dwight Howard because he cannot shoot free throws. And even though he's still young, still maturing.
And I'm tired of hearing that. The kid's been in the league 5 years.
Okay, but
he came straight from high school. He can't post up. Yeah. He is the most athletic
big
man.
Patrick is working with him, though. Oh, I mean,
he at least got a little hook. They need
to go get
Akeem Olajuwon, somebody who has some footwork to work with. Pat Ewing. Okay?
Patrick has shots, though.
Patrick has shots. Yeah, you can get up off of Georgetown there, buddy.
Apparently, he ain't teaching this kid how to shoot the ball.
Well, look at how he's progressed in these 5 years. I mean, what did Barkley say about him? If it wasn't for the dunk, he wouldn't be in the league.
Well,
see, he's not at that level anymore.
Yeah, 61% of his shots came on dunks and putbacks.
But he's progressed beyond that, where he's aggressively trying to take the ball to the hole.
Why? Because he knocked the hell out of his teammate there.
Wait a minute. But y'all jumping on him. Who's coaching him?
Nobody.
Okay. So that. Okay. I mean,
now y'all gonna go off on
okay.
Stan Van.
But
Stan
I'm just saying,
Gundy, come on.
The kid came out of high
Master
school,
Penny.
And then you come in and your coach is Stan Van Gundy.
Stan Van Gundy's your coach.
Okay, so what do you expect from him?
The great coaches coach in practice. You ever see Stan?
During
I'm telling
game,
you, I hope
down.
They got a defibrillator.
Okay, I'm telling you, he's melting down.
Yeah,
he gets caught up in the game. He's sweating. You know, I'm like, damn. You know, I'm looking at Ron Jeremy. My nipples get hard. You listen to the Don Miller Show. Give us a call 1-800-785-4366. We're going to take a minute to kind of get ourselves together in here. You can give us a call 1-800-785-4366. The local number 407-894-1680. When we come back, we're going to continue the dialogue with Jamel Hill. We're going to talk a little sports, talk a little politics, and figure out how a brother can get his stimulus check. We'll be right back.
You're listening to the Don Miller Show on the Urban Empowerment Network.